So, warm greetings. Warm greetings for this meditation session, our time together, and for the beginning of this week. And as we begin to get ready for this meditation, I would like to offer a wonderful principle of practice. And that is that the Dharma practice unfolds most harmoniously when the means of practice contains some of the goal, so that the means are not dramatically different than the goal, but that the goal is found in the means itself, in the practice. Even for someone who's practicing for the first time today, that it isn't that there's a goal far in the distance that we can attain, so much as, I mean, there is, but that we can discover some of those qualities even in the first time we sit down to meditate. And there's many qualities of awakening, but one of the qualities of awakening is awakening itself. The simplicity of being aware of what's happening, and simply being aware. Being aware without an agenda, without trying to go for a goal and attain something. A quality of awakening is an absence of greed, an absence of insistence and ideas of should. I have to do this, I should do this, it should be this way. I want to attain this, I want to do. There's a kind of, it could be a drive to want. And awakening also has an absence of resistance, an absence of being in contention with reality. You sit and meditate free of contention. And so here we are, and to be aware with the generosity of allowing each thing that arises, each experience we have, to allow it to be as it is. Liberation, the goal of practice, maybe is understood less as you become liberated, as it is everything becomes liberated from you. Everything becomes free of your needs, your expectations, your projections, your ideas, your associations. And that's particularly valuable when it's really having an intimacy and a connection to what's happening here with ourselves. To really be intimate and here and connected and deeply respectful enough to allow each thing its freedom. So to begin this process, to enter into our posture, and to gently close your eyes. To gently now enter into your posture and make small adjustments. Both to feel more comfortable in your posture, and maybe more alert, but also to awaken in your body, to bring a sense of attention alive in your body itself. Take a few long, slow, deep breaths. These long, slow, deep breaths at the beginning can be a ritual reminder that awakening happens here and now. That awakening is some aspect of being fully present here. Now. And as you exhale, just settle into now and here. Curious, interested in this awakening and freedom that can only be found here and now. And letting your breathing return to normal. Relaxing your belly. Relaxing your chest. Relaxing your face. Awakening, the goal of practice, has a quality, an aspect of deep relaxation, or an absence of tension, contraction. And to relax at the beginning of meditation is not an elementary beginning practice. To begin the process of being attuned and in harmony with awakening itself. And then to settle into the body breathing. And what is it, what would it be like for you to have an intimacy with your breathing, with the body's experience of breathing? Where that intimacy and attention, shared qualities of freedom, liberation. Freedom from shoulds. Freedoms from resistance to anything. Freedom from contention and struggles with how things are. Freedom freedom from needing things to be different at this moment. An awareness that grants each experience its freedom. Freedom from us and our ideas and desires. Each particular thing that occurs in the present moment, in our body, in our mind, in our hearts, allowing it to be without being involved in it, entangled, just letting it be here in its own simplicity. And then as we come to the end of this sitting, to see if you bring into your mind the people of your life, the ones you know of, the ones you imagine in the world, the peoples of your community. And if you imagine meeting them with an awakened mind or awakened heart, one in which there is no fear, no contention, no opposition, no hostility, and no defensiveness, no greed, being settled and content and happy in your own heart, and to open your heart to meet and be aware of people around you. And what would it be like if there were qualities of liberation or freedom, awakening, in how you meet others, how you encounter them? An encounter that's free of clinging, need, resistance, just present, but not in danger of succumbing to the demands of others, not in the danger of getting entangled in those relationships, because you're at home and resting in your own awareness. And perhaps then, in the safety of an awakened heart, to offer your goodwill to others, your sense of care and generosity. May it be that people I know could be happy. May it be that they could be safe. May it be that they can be peaceful and free. May it be that they can feel deeply safe and at ease and happy in themselves. And may it be that from whatever awakening or inner freedom we have, that we live our life for the welfare and benefit of others. May we ourselves and all beings share in happiness, safety, peace, and freedom.